Greetings to one and all present here. I, Anjali, from the team of Lexis and Company, today will give you a small brief about the doctrine of transfer of malice. Okay. So, first of all, we need to know where this concept has been provided under the Indian Penal Code, right? So, this is not expressly mentioned anywhere, right? But it is given under it can be inferred from Section 301 of Indian Penal Code. So going further, what do we understand by the term transferred malice, right? So transfer basically shifting from one place to another. And malice means ill will or ill intention, right? So when you have ill intention for one person, but it affects someone else, it gets transferred to someone else, that is known as the doctrine of transfer of malice. So the first question that arises in anyone's mind after hearing this is that, is this an excuse? Can this be used as an excuse that you intended to hurt one person, but you hurt somebody else? Is this an excuse in the court of law? So the answer to this is that no, this cannot be used as an excuse. Rather, you will be punished in the same manner, looking at your intentions. Okay, so I'll give you an example. If a person, he intends to kill B, but by mistake of fact or by an accident, he kills C instead of B. So the person will be punished in the same manner as if he had an intention of killing C. He will be punished for culpable homicide of C or murder of C, depending on the facts and circumstances of each case. Okay, this doctrine can also be considered to be one of the as an exception to the fact that, you know, in criminal law we say that mens rea is one of the most essential element of any crime. But here in doctrine of malice, transferred malice, the mens rea is not for the person who is at the end of it hurt, right? So here we can say that it is an exception. So now we'll look at some of the landmark cases in this topic. So the first landmark case is R versus Michelle. So here what happened, the appellant, they were in a queue and the appellant tried to jump the queue, which angered an old man who was also part of the queue. So he objected to his behavior, and being angered by that, the appellant, he tried to hurt the old person, right? He kicked him and he pushed him, but the person only sustained the injuries, but he fell on an old lady who was standing next to him, and she could not sustain the injury. She got killed. Right. So here the doctrine was applied. The doctrine of transfer of malice was applied, and the person, he was convicted in such a manner as if he intended to hurt or cause the death of the old lady. Okay. So now a recent case in this matter is from 2006 from India, and the name of the case is Rajbir Singh versus State of UP, where there was a person who had some grudges with his neighbor's father, right? So this person, he sent goons and who he wanted to shoot the father while he was buying groceries from a nearby shop. Now there was also a small kid there, okay, and she was buying some stuff from the shop, who got killed during the shooting, whereas the person who was supposed to be killed, he had injuries and he survived. So here also the accused was convicted under Section 301 of IPC, and it was a case of transferred malice. So I hope it was an informative lecture for you. And do like, share, and subscribe our channel. Thank you.